Did you know that writing the research purpose is the most important step in writing your research proposal or publication? I'm Laura Killam, a nurse researcher who can teach you how to write amazing purpose statements. The purpose needs to address a gap in the literature, something that is unknown. Understanding that your purpose must help fill a gap in knowledge is where a lot of students struggle. For this reason, you need to do some reading about your issue before formulating a study purpose or design. Research is unlikely to be funded or published if it does not clearly add something to the current literature base. I believe that every research proposal or publication needs a specific, concise, and clear purpose that is worded as a statement. Everything else in your study will be critiqued on its congruence with this one purpose statement, so choose your words wisely. Revisit the purpose statement often to be sure that each component of your study is congruent with it. If something is not congruent, then you need to change either the wording of the purpose statement or change whatever is incongruent. You want to remember the finer criteria of feasible, interesting, novel, ethical, and relevant when deciding on a general idea for your purpose. It is especially important to think of what kind of study is feasible, given your resources and expertise, before writing your purpose. It is important that you are able to finish the research you start. The purpose needs to guide the study, so you want to make sure it's worded in a way that is pragmatic. For example, if you have a background in qualitative research, but no quantitative research understanding, knowledge, or resources, you will probably want to word your purpose in a way that can be answered qualitatively. Due to space limitations in journals, you might not always see both the purpose and research questions or hypotheses listed. Yes, the purpose and questions are closely related, but they are not exactly the same. I will talk about that more in another video, but every study should have a clear purpose, especially in research or ethics proposals. Let's talk about how to write your purpose. A purpose statement needs to be clear. Don't get too fancy. Start with the purpose of this study or the aim of this study. Readers critiquing your study will thank you for making your purpose statement clear and easy to find. My favorite journals even go as far as to have a heading in bold that says aim or purpose. The purpose needs to be easily found. You can put your methodology right into the purpose statement by saying, the purpose of this phenomenological study, or the aim of this randomized control trial. However, explicitly stating the methodology is not necessary. The reader should still be able to tell from your purpose wording what paradigm your research should be in, and in most cases, have an idea of a more specific methodology that would be appropriate. Also, just because you name a methodology here doesn't mean that the rest of the purpose statement will automatically fit with that methodology. So continue to choose your words wisely and consider if they match the methodology you have chosen. Include a verb that indicates what your study will do. Choose this verb wisely. The verb you choose is going to give the reader an idea of what types of research methodologies and methods will be congruent with your purpose. There are different keywords that fit with each methodology. I recommend looking at some examples in the literature and reading a book with some information about how to select the right verb for your study. I have provided a few examples here and some helpful resources below the slide. What is required in the rest of the purpose statement depends on the methodology of your study. Let's talk more about qualitative purposes first, then I'll talk about quantitative purposes. I recommend you listen to both so you know the difference in how they are written.